This illustration demonstrates the deviation of a particle in uniform magnetic field. Here we can see a particle of charge plus Q and mass m enters a uniform magnetic field with a velocity vector 6 I cap meters per second. And we are given that the width of this magnetic field region is mv by 2 qb, that is half of the radius of its circle, because circular radii is mv by qb for any charge enters in magnetic field. We are required to find the velocity vector of particle when it comes out of the field. Here in this situation, we know the radius of circular path in magnetic field for any charged particle is mv over qb. And here the width of this sector of magnetic field D is given as R by 2 because it is mv by 2 qb. So when in this magnetic field the charge enters, it experiences an upward magnetic force. Say if here somewhere here on this y axis center of field is there and it follows a circular path and finally comes out with the same speed v because the speed never changes, but it is deviated by an angle of deviation delta. So here if this angle is delta, this is also delta, here is also the angle delta. So if this width is d, radius is r, you can directly write the angle of deviation of particle due to the sector of magnetic field is delta, which can be written as sine inverse of d by r. As d is r by 2, the sine inverse of 1 by 2, which is 30 degree. So if it comes out at an angle 30 degree, we can directly write down the components of the particle's velocity. Components of particles velocity are, here we can write Vx, which is V cos 30 degree. That is, the value of a speed is 6. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2, this 3 root 3 meters per second, and velocity in y direction is v sine 30 degree, that is 6 by 2, this 3 meters per second. So when it comes out, the final velocity vector we can write as vx I cap plus vy j cap, that is 3 root 3 I cap plus 3 j cap meters per second. That will be the answer to this problem.